Hi, I'm Rhea.
And I'm Evie.
And welcome to the Cinemagic Stay at Home Movie Show.
Welcome to the Stay at Home Movie Show, where we will be reviewing the best films you can enjoy from home. On this edition, we will be reviewing My Life as a Courgette.
Elle était gentille avec toi, ta maman?
Elle buvait beaucoup de bière, mais elle faisait de la bonne purée.
Bon, il est où ton papa?
Là.
Je vais t'emmener dans un endroit avec d'autres enfants comme toi, sans papa et sans maman.
Je vous présente votre nouveau camarade, Icar.
Il préfère qu'on l'appelle Courgette.
Moi, je dirais plutôt Patate, vu sa tête.
Simon, ça suffit.
Je vais rentrer chez moi, avec ma maman.
C'est impossible, Courgette. Elle est partie, ta maman, elle est au ciel.
Lâche ça!
Oh, trop balèze, Courgette.
On est tous pareils. Il n'y a plus personne pour nous aimer. On se lève. On se lave, Monsieur là, Paul, il nous raconte l'histoire des hommes qui étaient là avant nous.
Hé, hey, nouvelle, pourquoi t'es ici?
Toi, t'es le chef, c'est ça?
Ouais, voilà, ouais, t'as tout pigé.
J'ai quelque chose pour toi.
Cette fille dont tu m'as parlé, elle est comment?
Pas mal.
T'es amoureux?
N'importe quoi.
Mais bien sûr, mec, ça se voit à des kilomètres que t'es amoureux de Camille.
Camille doit passer le week-end avec moi.
Je te laisserai pas partir.
Viens là, ma petite chérie.
Ah trop cool!
Si on m'avait pas amené là, je t'aurais jamais connue. Ah on restera toute la vie ensemble.
Ouais on sourit.
Ouais. Alors, super couchette, c'est quoi tes super pouvoirs? Tu fais pousser les légumes plus vite?
Et toi, t'es déguisée en quoi? En débit?
What do our young cinematic reviewers think?
Today we're going to be talking about French film My Life as a Courgette.
This film is about a 9-year-old boy called Icar, who prefers to be called Courgette, being sent away to an orphanage. Although whenever he arrives, another boy called Simon is quite rude to him. And everything changes whenever Camille comes.
This film was an animation film.
I enjoyed this film and there were a lot of different emotions portrayed, and I felt them too. Although it was quite humorous at times, but I liked that. There was nothing that really stood out to me as being negative or something I didn't like.
I agree with that as well, but I've also noted that we learned of how much the children are suffering and lonely inside as they're missing their parents so much. The cast in this film, such as Gaspar Schlatter, Sistine Murat, and Michael Vernemals, were very good in their voice acting as they were able to portray the character and a voice that we couldn't imagine any other way. Their tones were on point and it was almost like they were in that situation themselves.
The director, Claude Barrès, did a very good job in outlining this story. All the people involved, whether it be the animation crew, the cinematography crew, the musicians, or the producers, did an outstanding job.
The target audience would be teenagers and those older who want some insight into the world of orphanages. We could see in this film how realistic it seemed of the situations that all the children went through to eventually become orphans. And finally, out of 5, I give this film a 4.
My name is John McGuire and this is the Cinemagic Preview Show. I reviewed My Life as a Courgette, which I consider to be a wonderful, heartwarming short film, though its subject matter is dark and quite sad. It focuses on a young boy named Courgette who is sent to a foster home after traumatic events. We follow his struggles as he tries to come to terms with the loss of his mother and life in a foster home. I could easily describe every single scene to you and explain why I like the film so much, but instead I'll just try and give you a brief overview. One of the main reasons this film works so well is that even though it has a dark and emotional subtext about the feelings of children who have been abandoned by their parents, it is also filled with laughter and joy. This joy is reinforced through colourful stop-motion animation. This central theme is shown very effectively in one key scene when the foster home kids take a trip to the Alps. We see them all skiing and just having a good time. Then a child in the background falls over and the little boy's mum comes rushing over them to comfort him. The camera then turns on to the foster kids who gaze at the mother comforting her child with longing in their eyes. I found this to be particularly effective because the director chose to hold on that shot for an uncomfortable length of time before cutting away, This moment emphasized the importance of family and of the lifelong pain that can be caused when parents let their children down. This film really resonated with me, and I think it would have a similar impact both on younger audiences and with teenagers. However, I also do think adults could really enjoy it because of the emotional depth that it produces. My life as a courgette allows any viewer to reflect back onto their own childhood. A person could relate to this film because they might have gone through a similar experience, but for others with different experience of childhood, they can be thankful for the upbringing they had and not be in these sorts of situations. Because of its impressive animation and the deeply striking and powerful story, I would happily give this film 4 out of 5. Bye.
Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe.